is Laura Fortman, who's the Commissioner of the Department of Labor, who's been a great partner both in the Children's Subcabinet, the Multicultural Subcabinet, the Employment Subcabinet. We have crossed paths in many places, and it is my pleasure to introduce her to you this morning.
Well, thank you. And my comments will be short. That's what I've been instructed to do. But I did want to start out by saying how much I've appreciated working with Commissioner Harvey over these last number of years. And one of the core ways that we can really help people in the state is by collaborating. And there is no commissioner who has worked harder to focus on the needs of the people she's serving rather than trying to garner individual credit than Commissioner Harvey. So it has been a pleasure working with you, Brenda. Thank you very much. As I was thinking about coming here today, I reflected on my journey at the Department of Labor, and one of the turning points for me was listening to a presentation by a woman many of you may know, Denise Bissonnette. How many of you have been to a workshop that she has done? Her focus is on really recognizing the inherent skills, talents, and abilities of everyone we come in contact with. So I was thinking about a story that she put in one of her books. And it's a story about a farmer who finds an egg. And he puts the egg in the nest of a barnyard hen. And it was actually an eagle egg. And the eaglet hatched with a brood of chicks and grew up with them. All his life, the eagle did what the barnyard chicks did, thinking he was a barnyard chicken. He scratched the earth for worms and insects. He clucked and cackled and thrashed his wings to fly a few feet into the air. Years passed and the eagle grew old. One day he saw a magnificent bird above him in the cloudless sky. It glided in graceful majesty among the powerful wind currents, with scarcely a beat of its strong golden wings. The old eagle looked up in awe. "Who's that?" he asked. "That's the eagle, the king of the birds," said his neighbor. "He belongs to the sky. We belong to the earth. We're chickens." So the eagle lived and died a chicken, for that is what he thought he was. And when I think of the work that all of you do every day, I think that this is apt, because frequently people are defining the people we work with in a way that's limiting, rather than recognizing the full potential that they have. And the people themselves start absorbing those same limitations. So what you're doing here today by rolling out a policy and programs that recognize the value, the talents, the skills that everyone brings to Maine and to employment opportunities, it's something to be celebrated, and you're recognizing that kind of inner eagle of the clients that you're working with. Employment for all Maine people is a core part of the mission of the Department of Labor. We do a couple of things. We try to help all people find jobs. If they lose their jobs, we try to make sure that they have that safety net of unemployment insurance. We provide good data so that hopefully employees and employers can make good decisions about what work opportunities are out there. And then we try to keep all workers safe on the job. So it's my pleasure to be here with you today. And I want to echo Commissioner Harvey's comments about the strong relationship and collaboration between DOL and DHHS, especially as it relates to employment of people with disabilities. Our two departments have been working hard over the past few years to make the delivery of employment services a more seamless process for job seekers and for service providers. And we're seeing good results from these efforts. I'm going to outline a couple of the things that I see as kind of shared accomplishments. First is the endorsement of single set of quality standards for employment service providers. Next, the design and implementation of a workforce development system for all employment specialists. We've redesigned the Employment for Me website as a resource for job seekers with disabilities, and also the Bureau of Rehabilitation Services in collaboration with DHHS and the Department of Administrative and Financial Services has entered a contractual agreement to procure hearing aids for eligible Maine clients. This contract is in the form of a cooperative multi-state agreement in association with Minnesota, Michigan, and Wisconsin. The state of Maine proceeded with these new contracts. They took effect on October 4th, and it's expected to result in a 70% cost savings for DHS and DOL clients. And I think that's significant. As Commissioner Harvey mentioned, we're frequently, as a system, as state agencies, attacked for not paying attention to how much things cost, when the reality is that on a regular basis, we are constantly looking for creative, innovative ways to both achieve cost savings and deliver quality services. And I think that this is a good example of that.